Un giorno spasseggiava in rosa bella di mamma. Un giorno spasseggiava per la via ed ascondava la rosa bella di mamma. Ad ascondava la calabrisella. Tutta sudata di rosa bella di mamma, tutta sudata di la quadriglia. Me la dono un poco da quella rosa bella di mamma, me la dono un poco da questa l'angela. Chi già risponde cue rosa bella di mamma ta, chi già risponde con una grazia bella.
My family, grandparents and great-grandparents on my paternal side, came from Sicilia, the Palermo region. And my maternal grandparents also came from Sicilia. However, my paternal grandmother actually hailed from the Abruzzo region, a small town called Scotto. I have not researched it, but certainly when I was growing up, I was very aware of the fact that I was Italian, that I was descended from Italian immigrant grandparents who came to America in their youth. My maternal grandfather, Matteo Orlando, came when he was 17, and he was working as a shepherd in Sicilia, and he came, and I was very proud of him in retrospect, because he learned the language not only of Sicilian, he already knew the language of Sicilian, but he learned Italian and English fluently, of course, with an accent. So I was very proud to be Italian-American, even though the second generation, my parents' generation, felt great shame for their ethnicity, which they eventually let go of as I moved into the area study of Italian-American studies. So in fact, my parents and then grandparents eventually moved from the New York area to Illinois, Southern Illinois, and then moved up into the Chicago area, which is where all four of my grandparents and then eventually my parents lived, and I lived and was raised as a child and educated there as well. So that's the brief family history. I do want to share one important fact that in effect, my grandparents didn't transfer the language of the dialectal language to their children. I also believe it was a sense of shame because they were living during the World War, the Depression and World War II generation. So all of that made it very difficult for them to feel comfortable with their identity, their cultural identities. But it didn't stop them from speaking it to themselves and from having a culinary heritage that was very evident in the food we ate. So that's the brief sort of history of myself, and it sort of prepared me to love the heritage identity that I was bequeathed by my parents and my grandparents and aunts and uncles as a child and into adolescenthood and adulthood. And it prepared me then to go on to study not only English and Anglo literature, but also American literature, which then led me into studying Italian American literature in the 1980s, I would say. And I want to share with you a brief anecdote. It was my mother that I thank for giving me the courage to work in the field of Italian American studies, because she was a bookworm and loved the library, and she was the one who was at the bookstore and discovered Helen Berolini's The Dream Book in 1985. And she was reading the introduction to The Dream Book, and she kept reading parts of it to me while I was studying literature at the University of Wisconsin at Madison, where I did my PhD in the Department of English. And because of her influence, I felt the confidence to move into studying Italian-American writers, specifically Italian-American women writers. And I had very important mentors at the University of Wisconsin at Madison who also studied heritage literatures, including African-American and specific women's writing. And I'm thankful to them as well. I feel like I stand on the shoulders of hundreds of people who made my life possible the way it is today.
Viene la mia celle rosa bella di mamata, ti dugno la que puro la mia vita. Raprimi bella cae rosa bella di mamata.
So I would have to say that 25 years later, I'm happy to say that in the United States, in certain universities, where I'm, especially the one I'm presently working at, Stony Brook University, in Stony Brook, New York, on Long Island, we can boast the fact that we have an Italian-American studies program. And I and another colleague a year before, Professor Gardafe, were we interviewed and we received jobs there, and we built the program in Italian American Studies. I came to Stony Brook in 1999 after 10 years working elsewhere, and I'm happy to say that the fruition of the work that we've done in our research became important on a curricular level at the university, and then the conversation extended outward into the major associations, academic associations, like the Modern Language Association. And in conjunction with the Calandra Institute, I was able to work with luminaries in the field, including Anthony Tamburi, and Fred Gardafe, and Bob Viscusi, and Edvige Giunta, and many others in the field that made possible the work that I'm doing. And the development of the field of Italian American studies has potential that's more what we call now in academia transnational. We're connecting with other countries, working with graduate students not only in Italy, but also in Australia, in Germany, in Scotland, and elsewhere. So it's been an exciting 20 years, and I couldn't have imagined it having such an international importance when we began working in the field. I'm in the field of literature, but I understand Italian American studies to be indeed an interdisciplinary event in which you must have very good knowledge of several disciplines, including history and psychology and sociology and gender studies, which is very dear to my heart. So over the last 25 years, working in this field has made possible the important istituto that has been developed at the University of Calabria with Professor Ganari and at Calandra Institute at Queen's College with Professor Tamburi, which makes possible this group of wonderful participants to get together from different disciplines and different area studies to talk about the field of Italian American studies, which indeed has changed over the years. It has a more transnational emphasis. There's more awareness of the importance of diaspora and how we are, in fact, as Italian Americans and as Italian historians, redefining that term so we can sort of participate in a very important conversation, not only about the great migration post-Risorgimento into the Americas and Australia and elsewhere, but also the migrations that are going on presently today, in which many other groups are coming into Italy and changing sort of the look and the feeling of all the different countries, including the United States. So I can say and conclude here by saying that Italian American studies has become a kind of much more cosmopolitan, transnational undertaking. And I'm glad to have been a small part of developing the field on a research level and a curricular level as well.
Alla promessa che mi ha dato. E io su di te sto rosa bella di mamata. E io su di te sto io benzina. rosa bella di mannata. Già vi dure già la saputa fare. A sa venire lui rosa bella di mannata.